Good day to all of you.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
You will be learning something new in today's class. But before that, let us revise what we learnt in the previous class. Can you tell why we use the sort option? With the use of sort, you can rearrange your table in ascending or descending order. Why is the filter option used? Using filter option, you can get information about the data in any row. Can you tell why we use the subtotal option? Using subtotal option, you can get the total of rows one by one, and you can also get the count for the rows. You can do many other tasks with the help of subtotal option. Why do we use text to column option? With the help of text to column option, if you have text which is joined by a comma, at the rate, etc., then you can view the same separately in a different column. Why do we use the today formula? With the today formula, you can insert the current date from your computer, meaning you can put the date on your sheet. Why is the year formula used? Using the year formula, you can get to know the year of any given date. If from a given date, you want to find out the month in that day, which formula will you use? If you want to get the month from any given date, then you will use the month formula for doing so. Now, all of you switch on your computers and using the method taught to you, open the Calc file. Let us now know what you will learn today. First, you will make a table and then you will learn about some options of the window menu like new window, close, freeze and split. Then you will learn about some formulas for char or character, ASC, concatenate, exact, find, left, right, mid, lower, upper, and trim. Now, make the table being shown to you, or you can open an existing saved Calc file. Can you tell why we use new window option? Using the new window, you can get another duplicate window of the one you are working on. Why do we use close window option? With the close window option, you can close your window. With the help of the video, let us now learn more about using the new window and close window options. Let us see in this video how we use the new window option. The new window option will create a duplicate window of the window that you are using. Or the file that you are using, it creates a duplicate file. To create a new window, take your pointer to the Windows menu of the menu bar and click on New Window. So you can see, as soon as you click on New Window, a new window with the same table is created for you. So you can see here, there is Untitled 1. At the back, you can see on top. And you can see Untitled 1-2, which is the duplicate file. So this way you can create a new window, which is an exact duplicate of the window that you were using. Now, if you don't want to use this or you want to close this, you can close it from the cross. And this way you can use the new window and close window options of the menu bar. You will now learn about the split. Do you know why is the split used? With the split formula, you can divide your sheet into four parts. By watching this video, we will learn more about using the split. Let us now learn about the split option. With the split option, you can divide your spreadsheet into four parts. And you can get the same data on all four parts. So let's first select the cell from where you want to divide the spreadsheet into four parts. Take your pointer to the window option of the menu bar and click on split. As soon as you click on split, you can see four parts of the spreadsheet have been made, and by scrolling on the scroll bars which are given, you can see that the same data has been put in all the four parts of the spreadsheet. So you can scroll up and down using the scroll bars here. As is being shown to you in the video, you can scroll here. Now let's see the data. Here you can see the data in the second part on the right side by scrolling. And if you scroll on the right end of the spreadsheet, you can see that the data is appearing in all four parts of the split sheet. So now whichever cell or row or column that you select in one of the sheets, the same will be selected in all four parts. So this is how you can use the split option to divide the spreadsheet in four parts. To bring it back to normal, go to Windows and click once again on split. And you will have your original spreadsheet back again. This way you can use the split option for your spreadsheet. Let's now learn about the freeze option. With the use of the freeze option, you can fix any row or column on your sheet. What this means is that once you have fixed the row or column, and then when you move the sheet up or down using the arrow keys or the pointer, then the fixed rows and columns will not move. These cells will remain in their place while the rest of the sheet moves up or down. With the help of the video, learn more about using the freeze option. Let us now see how we can use the freeze option to fix any rows or columns so that when we scroll up or down in the spreadsheet, those rows and columns are fixed. First, let's select the first row to be freezed or fixed and the first column. So we have to keep our cursor just after the first row and after the first column, which means that we have to select the B2 cell. So we take our pointer there, select that cell, then take the pointer to Windows, window option in the menu bar, and select freeze. As soon as you select freeze, one line just below the first row and one line just after the first column. This indicates that the first row and the first column have been fixed on your spreadsheet, or they have been frozen by using freeze. So if you see by scrolling up or down, or if you scroll left and right, let's see up and down first. So you see that as we go, keep on going down on our spreadsheet, the first row has been fixed. It is always visible to you. So you can keep going down on the spreadsheet or going up. That row which you have fixed will always be visible to you. Now let's see it for the column. The first column has been fixed. So if we scroll towards the right, and if we keep going towards more and more towards the right, the first column is always visible because it is fixed. We have used the freeze option to freeze the first column. So this is a very useful option which you can use when you have large spreadsheets and there is a lot of data. So you can have the title and the first column or any row and column that which you want, you can fix it by using the freeze option. If you want to again come back to normal and remove the freeze which you had applied, take your pointer to the window option, left click on that and click on the freeze option. So the freeze will be taken away or the fixed lines will go away. This is how you use the freeze option on your spreadsheet. Now all of you will learn about some new formulas. Let's learn about the char or character formula. With the help of the char formula, you can find out the location number for any alphabet, number or symbol. You can know this for all symbols of the keyboard. Let's watch and learn from the video. We will now see the use of the character formula or the char formula. With character formula, you can find out which character lies at a particular number that you give in the character formula. So firstly, select the cell where you want to apply character. So we are going to apply. So in the first row of the H column, we write CHAR. And in the next cell, we type the formula for character, which is equal to, and then we type CHAR. Begin the bracket with shift and 9. And then type the number where you want to check the character. We type 50. Close the bracket with shift and 0. And press enter. So you see it says 2. Which means that the 2 appears at 50. Let's once again do this, equal to CHAR, begin bracket, and then we have typed 100, close the bracket, and press enter, and it shows us that D, the character D is at 100. So, this way we can be using the character formula. Once again, we are typing equal to CHAR, bracket begin, 20, bracket close, press enter. And this time, you see that it gives you a blank, which means that at 20, there is a blank. Once again, we type equal to CHAR, begin bracket, and then type 30 this time. Close the bracket, press enter. Again, it returns a blank. It shows a blank at 30. Next, we are typing equal to CHAR. And then we have to type some numbers. So we are typing 145 this time. Close the bracket and press enter. So you can see it has shown you a comma. So it has returned a comma, which means that at that location, a comma is there. Again, equal to CHAR, begin the bracket, 79 is the number we are using, close the bracket, and it shows a capital O at that location. So this way, for any number, we can use the character formula to find what character lies there. Let's now learn about the concatenate formula. With the concatenate formula, you can join two pieces of text into one. For example, if your first name and surname appear in separate columns, then you can use concatenate to bring them together in one column. With the help of the video, learn more about the concatenate formula. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the concatenate formula on our spreadsheet. With the help of concatenate, you can bring separate text or numbers which are written in different cells or columns into one column. So you can bring these together. So first of all, let us decide where we have to use the concatenate formula. Let us write some words first which we want to concatenate. So we've written www in the first column, A column. Then in the next one we have typed a dot. Then in the next one we have typed computer. In the next one we have typed shiksha. And in the next column we have typed a dot again, as is being shown in the video to you. And then we type ORG in the F column. So actually this is the website for computer shiksha, www.computershiksha.org. But we have typed all these words in separate columns. And we want to now use the concatenate formula to put all of these words together in one column. So let's first type, as we usually do with any formula, let's type a title here. Since we are going to use concatenate, let's type concatenate. 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 Now in the cell below, let's type the formula for concatenate and try to get all these words in one column. So to type the formula, we have to begin with equal to and then type concatenate to use the formula. So once again, you need to type the whole word concatenate, then begin the bracket, and then you can see after that you're supposed to type the text 1, text 2, text 3 separated by semicolons. So we have selected www, then we have typed the semicolon, then we have selected the dot, again semicolon. Like this we have selected all of these words separated by semicolons. You can also select by using your mouse or the keypad. Then close the bracket and press enter, and you can see all the words have come now in one column itself, in the first column itself. So you can see you have www.computershiksha.org in one column itself. Let's use one more example. Let's type www again. And then in the next column, type a dot. This is how you usually type a web address. So we are typing www dot. In the next column we type Google. Now we are typing the address for Google. Google and then dot again. And then in the end we have to type com, C-O-M. So after typing, now we want to bring this entire, all these words as one, because actually the website is www.google.com. So we need to use the concatenate formula. So we select the cell and then we type equal to concatenate, concatenate, begin bracket, and then select the word. First word is www, we select that. Then we type a semicolon. Then we select the dot, then we type semicolon, then we select Google, again semicolon, like this. You can select all of these words as you already have learned. Close the bracket and then press enter, and you can see in the first column we will get www.google.com as is being shown in the video. Once again, let's practice it one more time to know that we have learned this correctly. So we type equal to, and then the formula for concatenate, concatenate, concatenate. Begin the bracket with the shift and the 9 key. And then this time we'll select one of the texts which is already there in our spreadsheet. So we select A. From the A column, we select in the second row A. Type a semicolon, and we select the English marks for A, which is 78, and close the bracket. So now you notice that you can select text and numbers also. So this is how you can use the concatenate formula to get all the text or numbers which are in different columns in one column itself where you want them. Let's now learn about the exact formula. With the exact formula, you can check whether any text on your sheet is exactly the same or not. If you have given even an extra space in the text, then also it will be shown as a mismatch. Let us learn from the video about using the exact formula. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can use the exact formula. With the exact formula, you can check if the content, the text or the numbers in one cell is the same as the other. So first, let's type the title exact, EXACT, where we want to apply the formula, in which column we want to apply. And then in the next cell, let's type the formula for exact, which is equal to EXACT, begin the bracket with shift and 9, and then it says text 1 semicolon text 2. So we are selecting text 1 as A in this video, then we put a semicolon and select text 2, which is B in this video. Close the bracket with shift and 0 and press enter. Since both the values were not the same, the answer is false. The first one, text 1 was A, text 2 was B. So they were not the same, it says false. Now, let's use the exact formula one more time. This time we are typing some text. In this cell we have typed A. In the other cell also we have typed A. And also see that we have not given any spaces, so they are both exactly the same. So now we type the exact formula equal to exact, begin bracket, select the text 1, which is small a, then put a semicolon, and then select the text 2, which is also small a. And there are also no spaces or anything extra. It's exactly the same as the first one. Then we close the bracket and press enter. And you can see the answer given is true, because both the values were small a. Without any spaces, they were exactly the same. Let's try using the exact formula one more time. Equal to EXACT, begin the bracket with shift and 9 key, and then let's take a number this time. So we are taking 78 as text 1, put a semicolon and select text 2 as 84. Since they are not the same, when you close the bracket, press enter, the answer will be false. Let's try one more time. This time we are just showing you that the first text was 79, the second was 84. They were not the same. So the answer to the exact formula is false. One more time. Let's take numbers again. And let's take the same numbers this time. So we type equal to exact. And then text 1 we are selecting as 69. Put a semicolon. And then we are selecting another 69. So both the numbers are the same. Close the bracket. Press enter. And you see the answer is true. This is so because both the numbers were the same. There were no spaces. They were exactly the same. We will now learn about the find formula. With the help of the find formula, you can search for any text or symbol in a given text. Watch the video to learn more about find. With the help of this video, let us now see the usage of the find formula. With find, you can find any character or text from a cell and know its position in that cell. So let's first type the title find where we want to apply the formula. So we are typing it here as is being shown in the video. And then in the next cell, let's type the formula, which is equal to find, find. And then we have to begin the bracket. So equal to find, begin bracket with shift and 9. And then it says type the find text. So to type the find text, we have to start inverted commas and type the text that we want to find. For instance, if we want to find computer from this cell, we'll first start after the bracket, begin the inverted commas, type computer, close the inverted commas, then put a semicolon, and then select the cell from where you want to find the position of computer in that cell. So we've selected that, then we close the bracket and press enter. Let's see this once again. Let's try to find the word com. Let's try to find the position of the word com in www.google.com. So we're typing equal to find, begin bracket, begin the inverted commas, then type the word, exact word that you want to find, com, close the inverted commas, semicolon, and then select the cell from where you want to find the position. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see it shows you the answer as 12 because www dot and Google and then dot again, these are 11 positions, and at the 12th position com is appearing. So this way you can use find to find any text and find its position in the cell. One more time, let's find 8 in A78. Let's find the position. So we type find equal to find, bracket begin, begin the inverted commas, type 8, close the inverted commas, semicolon, and then select that cell, A78, that cell. And close the bracket, press enter, and you can see the answer will be 3 because 8 is after A and 7. So it's at the third position. So this is how you will be using find to find the location of any text in a cell on your Calc sheet. Let us learn about the left formula. Using the left formula, you can decide for your text how many characters you want to show or see from the left side. Watch the video and learn about using the left formula. In this video, we are going to learn how to use the left formula on our Calc sheet. Write or make visible the number of characters from the left side from a cell. So let's first type left as the title, L-E-F-T. Then in the next cell, we are applying the formula, which is equal to, and then L-E-F-T, as is being shown in the video. Then begin bracket. It says, select the text. So we select the text from where we want to see, find the number of characters. So we have selected the concatenate word. Then we put a semicolon and then we type the number of characters that we want to see. So we want to see 3 characters from the cell. Close the bracket and then press enter. So the first 3 characters of the word concatenate, C-O-N, appear in this cell where we have applied this formula. Similarly, let's try once more. Let's use this once more. So equal to L-E-F-T, begin bracket with shift and 9 key. This time we are selecting the www.computershiksha.org, that cell. Put a semicolon and then type the number of characters you want to see in this cell from the left side. So we want to see the 6 characters of this particular cell where we have applied the formula. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see the first 6 characters of www.computershiksha.org, which is www.co. The first 6 characters have come there. One more time, let's practice using left formula. Equal to left, begin the bracket, select the text. So this time we are using the text as from www.google.com, that cell. Type in the semicolon and then type the number of characters you want to see or show from the left side. So we are typing, this time we are typing 9. So we want to see 9 characters from there. Close the bracket and then press enter. So you can see www, that's 3 characters, dot g-o-o-g-l. So in all, it shows 9 characters from the left side. Let us now learn about the right formula. With the right formula, you can decide for any text how many characters you want to show or see from the right side. Watch the video and learn more about the right formula. With the help of this video, we will now learn how we can use the right formula on our spreadsheet. So the right formula will select as many characters as you want to see or show from the text that you select and will print them in the cell that you have selected. So first of all, let's type right as the title where we want to apply the right formula in the column where we want to apply. So R-I-G-H-T. Then in the cell below, we will type the formula for right equal to R-I-G-H-T, begin the bracket, and then it says select the text. Then put a semicolon and put the number of characters that you want to see or show. So we have selected the text, concatenate, that cell. And then put a semicolon. Then we type the number of characters we want to see or show from the right side in the cell. So we have typed 4. So you can see when we press close the bracket and then we press enter, you can see the 4 characters N-A-T-E, which are on the right side of that cell concatenate, appear in this cell. Once again, we do equal to R-I-G-H-T, begin the bracket and select the text. Notice that this text that we are selecting in cell B13 would be blank because www.computershiksha.org is written in the A13 cell. But let's see what happens. We have selected that cell, put a semicolon, put 3 as characters that should appear on from the right side, and when we press enter, it shows a blank, because from a blank cell, even if you want to see 3 characters, they will still be blank. So this time, let's select the right cell equal to RIGHT for the right formula. Begin the bracket and then select A13 where the cell says www.computershiksha.org. Put a semicolon and put 3 characters to be shown. Close the bracket. Press enter and you can see the rightmost 3 characters ORG appear in the cell that we had selected. Let's do this one more time. Equal to, and this time we are going to select the cell www.google.com. So equal to right, begin the bracket, then select that cell which is A14, put a semicolon, and this time we are saying we want 10 characters from the right side. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see 10 characters, which is google.com, appears in the cell that you had selected. So this is how you can use the right formula on your spreadsheet to get the rightmost characters that you want to see or show on your spreadsheet. Let us learn now about using the mid formula. When you want to decide on how many characters you want to show or see from the middle of any text, then you will use the mid formula. We will learn more about the mid formula by watching this video. Let us now see how we use the mid formula. So let's type mid as a title, as is being shown in the video, and in the cell just below, let's type the formula equal to mid, then start the bracket, and then you have to type the or select the text that you want to find the characters from the middle of. So we have selected this www.computershiksha.org, put a semicolon, and now you have to type the start number, which means the number of characters after which you want to find the text in the middle. So we say www dot, so that's 4 characters, so we are putting 4 here, and then you have to give the put a semicolon and then give the number of characters that you want to see from the middle of the text in this cell. So since computer is what we want, we will type 9 here. So the 9 is the number of characters that we want. Close the bracket and press enter, and you can see that you get C-O-M-P-U-T-E-R, computer, in the cell that you had selected. Once again, let's see the use of mid. Equal to mid, begin bracket, then select the text. This time we are selecting www.google.com. Put a semicolon, then give the start number from where the middle text should start. So we are saying the fifth word or the fifth character, which is G-O-O-G-L-E, we want that. So we type 5 here. We want 4. Yes, we have to type 5 here and then semicolon, and then we type the number of characters that we want to see from the middle of this selected cell. So we are typing G-O-O-G-L-E, 6 characters. So we close the bracket and press enter, and you will see the word Google appears. Let's see this one more time with a simple example from the A78 cell. So we type equal to mid, begin the bracket, and then select this text A78. We want to find 7. We want to just print 7. So we say from this cell, put a semicolon, then start from the second character. That is what we are saying. And semicolon, count number is 1. We just want 1 character from the middle. Close the bracket and press enter. And you see 7 gets printed in this cell where we had applied the mid formula. Let us now learn about the lower formula. With the lower formula, you can show any text you want in lowercase. The text will then be displayed in small letters. Let us now learn how we can use the lower formula in our Calc files. With the lower formula, you can convert any text which is in capital letters to small letters. For instance, first we will type this title lower, L-O-W-E-R, as is being shown in the video to you. And then in the next cell just below that, let us type the formula for lower, which is equal to L-O-W-E-R, then begin bracket, and then select the text. So we have selected computer, which is written in capitals. Close the bracket and press enter, and you will find computer written in small letters in the cell where we had applied the formula. One more time, equal to lower, bracket begin, and then we select Google, which is written in capitals. Close the bracket, press enter, and we find Google written in small letters here. Again, equal to lower, begin the bracket, then we select the word text written in capitals. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see it written in small letters here. So this way, you can convert any letters or any cell in capital letters to small letters on your sheet. We now learn about the upper formula. With the upper formula, you can convert any text that may have been written in small letters to capital letters. Watch and learn more about the upper formula. Let us now use the formula for upper. The upper formula will change the small case of letters or text written in small letters to capital letters. So firstly, where we want to apply the upper case, we are just writing the title UPPER. Then in the next cell just below that, let's apply the formula, which is equal to then the word upper, UPPER, as is being shown to you in the video. Then begin the bracket with shift and 9 key, and then it says text. So select the text which is in small letters. So we are selecting the word computer written in small letters. And then close the bracket with shift and 0. Press enter, and you can see that the word computer, which was written in small letters or small case, is now written in capital letters. Once more, let's see the usage. We put the formula first, type the formula equal to upper, UPPER, begin the bracket. This time let's select the word Google. Again, Google is written in small letters. And close the bracket, press enter, and you can see immediately you get the word Google written in capital letters in the cell where you had applied the formula. Let's practice this one more time. Equal to upper, begin bracket, and then let's select the text, which is text itself, T-E-X-T. So if you select that cell, close the bracket and press the enter button, you can see T-E-X-T gets written in capital letters in the cell where we had applied the formula. So this way you can use the upper formula to change any small letters text into capital letters on your sheet. Convert your file into the PDF format and then save your file. Since today's class ends here, now close your file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, you all learned about some options of the window menu, like new window, close, freeze, and split. Then you learned about some formulas for char or character, concatenate, exact, find, left, mid, lower, upper, and trim.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
Thank you.